Hello friends, welcome to YouTube channel Kaiaswin. So today in this video I am going to create a vintage clock, as well as I am going to create the dial of that clock. So friends, watch the video till the end so that you will get full information that how you can also create the same design. So friends, this is the fourth part of the video where I am going to create the clock. So if you are not to watch my first part, second part and the third part, then please watch that part too. So without any further ado, let's start the video and let's create a vintage clock in Blender. So basically I used a cylinder, as well as I am using Blender add-on known as hard ops and box cutter. So if you don't have, you can go to the Blender site and you can download it very easily. So let's now create the remaining part of the clock. As I have created the basic shape of the clock, as you can see on my screen, so now let's create a material so that it will give some realistic feeling. So first you have to click or say increase the metallic value so that it will give a feel of a metal, and you have to change the color, as well as you have to decrease the roughness value so that it will give a metallic feel, as well as it will be reflective. So once you have done all of this material, now let's create the dials of the clock. So to create the dials of the clock, I will mention or I will tell you that you have to download the image of dial. You can download the image from Google. Just type that download Google clock dials, then you can download that dial. Then just assign to that particular area, select that face and assign the image to it. And once you have done this, I am now extruding little bit backward so that we can create the dial portion easily, as well as we can create a reflective glass after this step. So now let's do the UV unwrapping portion quickly. So doing the UV unwrapping portion is the simplest portion for this tutorial, as well as in the first part, second part and third part I have also explained you that how you can perform that UV unwrapping texture part. So let's scale it down and just fastly do the unwrapping portion. So let's give it a render sort out so that we can see that exactly how our UV unwrapping has been applied to the portion of the clock. And once you have done the UV unwrapping, now let's create the dial of that clock. So I thought that rather using a texture which was the inbuilt texture that I used for that I used in the clock, rather using that texture, let's create a new dials for the clock. So to create the dial for the clock, as we know that in a clock there are three dials, which is a second hand, minute hand and hour hand. So to let's create that dial quickly. So to create that, we can use a plane, and as in the third part I have explained you that how you can create a logo, in that similar way you can also create the clock dial. So to create it, just use a simple plane. You can press shift A and use the plane to create it. Once you have aligned the plane, then just use cut tool, or the shortcut is K, and just create a cuts according to the texture that you can see on the screen. And once you have created the texture and created the line, just press enter, and then you can delete the remaining portion. As you can see, I have also deleted the remaining portion. So in this method you can create the other dials, or like the second hand, minute hand and hour hand. And once you have created it, so friends, watch the video till the end so that you will get full knowledge that exactly how I am going to create this 3D model. Thank you for watching the video till now friends. If you like the video, do press the like button, and also don't forget to press the subscribe button, and also don't forget to press comment so that I will get motivated and I will create such more tutorials for you. Then just do the extrusion, little bit of extrusion, so that you can extrude it at some height. And once you have done the all this step, like creating a plane, cutting it and excluding it, then just align the tiles to the clock so that it can give a realistic feeling, that rather using just a text. Now if we assign any lights, or say we assign a light in the rendering, then we can easily feel the shadow of the dial. So in this manner you can create the basic clock shape, as well as you can create the basic dials, as well as you can do the UV unwrapping and texturing for the clock. But this is not the end friends. Now I will tell you how to create a glass. So for creating a glass, you can use basically a spear. So I am using a spear and just scaling up in the size of a glass. You can see my screen. And once you are done, what I have did is that I have created another cube so that I can remove some part of the spear, and the half part can be only visible in the rendering portion and the other half part will be get deleted. So to do this, I have used box cutter add-on. You can also use the boolean method, which is also the simplest method to do. Just use boolean method to remove the unwanted portion of the spear, and once you have used it, you can use smooth option or you can use turbo smooth to smooth it out, and just now assign some materials to it. As I have told you that we are making a glass material, we can do is that just increase the transmission value and decrease the alpha to 0.5 so that it can be little bit transparent, as well as you have to decrease the roughness value so that it can be more transparent. So as well as I have used another material known as transparent material, as well as I use the mix shader, and I have connected the node to the main principal BSF. Once you have done it, now let's create more realistic clock. Like we know that in real life, in clock or say on the surface of the clock, there are smudges or say thumbprint. So let's create the thumbprint now. So to creating the thumbprint, you have to download a thumbprint texture or say PBR material. So to download the PBR material, you can easily go to the Google and you can download the PBR material from textureimages.com. So once you have downloaded the PBR material, so if you don't know what a PBR material, so let me tell you that basically PBR material are all the materials like which contains normal map, basic color, as well as which contains specular, roughness value, displacement value and other values. So now let's create the thumb impression on the glass surface. So to do this, I have downloaded the thumb impression. So I have just connected it to the base color input through the node, and then I have used the normal map and I have connected the normal map to the bump area, and then I connected it to the normal input of the BSF principal shader. Now let's create the roughness. As we all know that we get different type of materials, so now let's create the roughness. So I have used color map to create the roughness. So once you have done it, you can now see that we have created a realistic looking glass, as well as we have created a realistic looking clock. So friends, now let's create the remaining part of the clock, like the stand and the holder. So to do it, you can watch the video. It is also the simplest method. I have just selected some faces of the basic shape of the clock, then I have just duplicated that faces, then I have separated it from that original shape of the cylinder, and then I have just excluded it out. And once I have excluded it out, then you can see the handle of that clock. So now let's assign it and give some more detail. Like let's create a cylinder and let's give it some more detail so that it will look more realistic in while rendering. So in this manner you can create a clock, and in this manner you can do the realistic rendering in Blender. So if you like the video, don't forget to press the like button, as well as don't forget to press the subscribe button, as well as don't forget to press the bell icon so that whenever I upload the video you will get the notification. So in this part I have explained you that how you can create a realistic looking clock in Blender. So this part was the fourth part. So this is not the end of the series. So now in the next series I will explain you how you can create realistic looking phones, as well as how you can create realistic looking cables. The cables means that how you can create the Mac cables so that it will give a realistic feel, as well as how you can. So friends, thank you for watching the video till the end. So friends, goodbye. See you in the next video. Watch the next video too. Goodbye friends. Bye bye.